I greet you this morning in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And welcome to our Sunday celebration. Today we welcome Byron and Cassie Mastriano and their family to First Covenant. Their daughter Ellison will receive the sacrament of holy baptism during our service. Next Sunday, Faith Community will return and be with us in worship for our communion celebration. At the close of the service next week, there will be a joint meeting of both church councils in the fellowship hall. Please take the time to look over the announcements on the back of your bulletin. And before we stand for the call to worship, will you please join me in the prayer of Jabez? As printed on the back of the bulletin. Let us pray together. Oh, that you would bless us in your need and enlarge my territory, that your name would be with me, and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain. Amen. Will you please stand for the call to do that? It is no accident that the world exists.
It is no accident that we pass through the storms of life.
It is no accident that we find ourselves bringing children to the baptismal font.
It is no accident that we find ourselves in prayer.
It is no accident that we find ourselves in prayer. It is no accident that we find ourselves passing through these doors to the holy place. No matter where you have been, no matter how far you have drifted away,
God says, I have redeemed you, you are mine.
Our hymn of praise is holy water.
Thank you.
other confession, that the baptism of Jesus in the river Jordan, he proclaimed him to be God's son, and anointed him with the Holy Spirit. Grant that all who are baptized into his name, may keep the covenant in their name, and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who in you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and everlasting. Amen. Let us sing our choral response. Blessed be the time that binds. Father, in your divine mercy, we come before you this morning, and we do lift up to you our nation. We pray, O God, for the healing of our nation. We also pray for the first responders and the nurses and the physicians who care for those who are very ill today. We pray, O God, that the time will come that we can come together live together as you would want us to live. We thank you for this day, a day that has been set aside to celebrate our baptism and to celebrate the baptism of Allison. We just pray that as our family brings her to their baptismal font, that your precious Holy Spirit would surround this family and they would know just how much that you love them. We do pray for those in our parish who are shunned and who will be watching later today on their website, that your blessing would be upon them. We do continue to pray for Jack, who is with us today, and we just ask for your blessing to be in his life. We pray for Tom as he still struggles with his breathing, that your touch would be upon his life. We thank you that we can be in your house and have the freedom to worship you in spirit and in truth. And for this we give you the praise and the glory in the wonderful name of Jesus, who taught all of us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day.
since we opened back up 6 weeks ago, there were some changes that we had to make in our format of worship. And so one of the things was that the offering plates were placed in the back of the sanctuary, and as people came in, they dropped their offering in the offering plate, or they dropped it in on their way out. But we do have a time when we want to praise the Lord and give thanks for your faithfulness. And so would you stand and join us as we sing the doxology as Joe, our head usher, brings our offering to the front. Dear friends in Christ, Through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us without Christ. On behalf of our faith community, do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to all people? If so, answer, I do. Will you nurture Ellison in the Christian faith, that by your teaching and example, she may be guided to accept God's grace for herself, to profess her faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? If so, answer, I do. For the congregation, please rise. I now ask the family and all of you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church, the faith in which you've been baptized. Do you, as Christ's body of the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? If so, answer, we do.
Amen.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, and in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life? If so, answer, we do.
Amen.
Do you receive and profess the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments? If so, answer, we do.
Amen.
Do you promise, according to the grace given you, to keep God's holy will and commandments and walk in the same all the days of your life? If so, answer, we will.
Amen.
Please be seated. And now we'll stretch out your hands towards the baptismal font as I pray the prayer of dedication and consecration over the baptismal font. Almighty God, we call upon you to pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water, that if Ellison comes for holy baptism, she may receive your blessing upon her life and be filled with your Holy Spirit. Receive her as you have promised, and grant that she may be faithful to you all the days of her life, and finally come to the eternal kingdom which you have promised through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends, remember your baptism and be thankful. Sign of her baptismal covenant, I place this baptismal call upon her. And by the sign of the cross, Ellis and Marie, by the sign of the cross, you are sealed forever as a child of Jesus Christ. Back of your bulletin. Friends of the household of faith, I commend to your love and care Ellison, who we this day recognize as a member of the family of God. Will you endeavor so to live that Ellison may grow in the knowledge and the love of God through our Savior, Jesus Christ. With God's help, faith community, I present to you Ellison Marie Astriana, newly baptized child of God. Ellison Marie will have major surgery the 1st of September at Shriners Hospital in Philadelphia. And so, again, stretch out your hands and we're going to pray. Watch your mind. Father, we thank you for Ellison. We thank you that your parents brought her to the baptism of fire to receive your blessing. Now, Father, we pray that your blessing will be upon her and her family. That you will bless everyone who will be involved with her surgery. And in your providence, we pray that you will be in Jesus' name. Can we give God the praise?
At peace with each other. The gospel of the Lord for today. Thanks be to God.
God grant us now the strength to the inner peace to accept the things of life which we simply cannot change. The grace and the power of the Holy Spirit to change the things we can and the wisdom to know the difference. Through the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength. There is an old story about a man who possessed the most beautiful old ring ever made. And over the years, he discovered when he wore the ring, his whole character changed for the good. He had three sons whom he loved very much and didn't want to decide who was to receive the ring when he passed away. And so he had two other rings made, and no one could tell them from the real old ring. So on his deathbed, he called each of his sons in to see him. He spoke words of love to them, and without telling the other, gave a ring to the son, telling them to wear it and to allow it to work its magic in their lives. Be kind and gentle, and love one another, he said to them. Well, after his death, the sons discovered they each had the ring, and they became angry and wanted to know who had the real ring. And it finally ended up in court, and the judge ordered the three rings to be examined by an expert to decide who had the real ring. And when the results came back, the expert told the court they couldn't tell them apart. So the judge said to the three boys, while this court cannot prove which of you has the real ring, you can prove it to yourselves by the way that you live out your life. So go your way, be happy. Live out your life, be kind to one another, be truthful. Be just, be moral, and just love one another. I like this story because it points us in the same direction as our gospel lesson for this morning. One day, Jesus found his disciples arguing about which one was more important in their ministry team for Jesus. And Jesus caught them. And when he asked them what they were arguing about, they were silent because they really didn't know what to say that Jesus had caught them. And then to get away from the question, the disciple John asked Jesus another question. He said, you know, the other day, we saw a man casting out demons in your name, doing good works. And we told him to stop because he was not one of us. Lord, help us. And Jesus responded with a double-edged statement. If he is doing good works in my name, that's good. In other words, leave him alone. And you see, dear friends, Jesus didn't want to get caught up in the game of which is more important, to believe right or to do right. But rather, Jesus put the two together in a way which proves they simply cannot be separated. The two must be together in order for either one to be real. And this is what I want to focus our few moments on this morning. I want to make two statements that we can base our lives on. And the first statement is this: what you and I believe about the gospel of Jesus Christ and his mercy is so critical in how we live out our lives day by day. What we believe makes all the difference in the world. What we believe dictates how we perceive our world and how we understand our life, and yes, how we deal with our own past. If we believe life is only a test or a trial, then we will find no real joy in living out our lives. But if we truly believe and understand God's divine mercy and grace and love for us, and we see this as a gift of grace because of the cross of Jesus, we will always feel good about ourselves, regardless of what we might be facing in life. And we will have meaning and direction in our lives, come what may. The second statement is this: what we believe is important, but our faith, our personal faith in Jesus Christ, calls for us to reach out to others in the name of Jesus. You see, friends, our belief system calls for us to be the feet and the arms and the voice and the mercy and the justice of Jesus, reaching out to all people. Faith without mercy, faith without justice, will die. Just as good works without faith is hollow and empty, and in time will fade away because one will just burn out doing good works. The second part of this gospel has to do with the way that we treat children. While the disciples were fighting about who was the greatest on their ministry team, Jesus picks up a little child, puts him in his arms, and says, whoever welcomes one of these children in my name welcomes me. And then over the 10th chapter of Mark, Jesus went on to say, let the little children come to me, and do not stop them. For the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. And again, Jesus took the children in his arms and placed his hands on their head and blessed them. And friends, so should we. Children like Allison and Marie is a special gift from God. And it is our responsibility to make sure that all of our children grow and mature not only in age, but grow and mature in the faith that they were baptized in. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And this is why children's ministry and youth ministry in any faith community is so important. When we baptize a precious baby, like Allison, we make a covenant with God that as a faith community and as parents, we will provide for the spiritual needs of the children. And I have found over the years, when the dollars are put in the children's and youth ministry, and celebrate, there you will find the church alive and well, making disciples of all people. The Gospel of Mark ends this passage of Scripture with these words. Jesus said, have salt in yourself. Well, what in the world does that mean? I know what it means if you're on a salt-free diet. But I believe it means Jesus is calling all of us to live out our faith and make a difference. If you believe Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, then through the power of the Holy Spirit, God calls for us to share the love of Jesus by the way that we live out our lives. If we believe God has forgiven us, then we are given the power through the Holy Spirit to forgive others. My grandmother used to say, when I was younger and I was bragging about what I was going to do in the future, she would pause and she would smile and she would just say, well, you know, George, talk is cheap. And then she would say, we'll see. The proof is in the pudding. And over the years, we have all heard this. Well, I believe what she was trying to say to me, if it's true and right and correct and moral and loving and honest, it will show in the way that you live out your life. Over the years, I've come to believe with all my heart that this is the very core of our Christian faith and walk. If our faith is real and genuine, then make no mistake that our actions will follow. And they will be good, and they will be right, and they will be correct, and they will be moral. And yes, they will be honest. In 1988, at the Olympics, Greg Louganis won the gold in diving. But he won it under great adversity. Just 28 years old, he hit his head on the board on his next to last dive. And on his final effort, he needed a near-perfect dive to win the gold. And after the dive, a sportscaster asked him how he reassured himself to even try the dive after hitting the board. But Greg thought for a moment, and then he said, I kept telling myself, no matter how I do, I know my mom will still love me, regardless. And we know that he nailed the dive and let him go. Well, friends, this is the good news of the gospel, isn't it? God, in his divine mercy, loves us regardless. And Jesus calls for us to be faithful in all that we do, no matter what. Make a difference. Be a witness with your lives to a hurting world. The disciples were arguing about who was the greatest among them. And Jesus called. And Jesus said, whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all. And then he said, anyone who gives a cup of cold water in my name belongs to me and will be rewarded. Be a witness. Like the old story about the open ring. The judge said, basically, what my grandmother said, the proof is in the way you live out your life. And so he said to the three boys, go your way. Live a good life. Be kind to one another. Be truthful. Be moral. Be just. And the one who does these things will be the true owner of the great. Well, Well, friends, our gospel for today calls for us to do the same. Be faithful in all that we do, no matter what. And God will bless. The proof, yes, is in the pudding. And will prove the way that we will not have lives. At the sound of the music, let us stand and sing, shine, Jesus, shine. Thank you. Lake. Let's give them another hand. Now receive the blessing. Let the healing streams of God's love wash over you. Let the dwelling waters of Jesus quench your thirst. Let the river of life, the renewing spirit, guide you in all truth. Go in God's peace, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Please be seated, and the usher will dismiss us from the back room. We ask that the waiting be outside the social distance. Thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you.